In yesterday's video, I talked about today, tomorrow, referring to today, being the 840th day of something, and I couldn't remember what, and I went on past it, but paralleling the 840 days of petitioning him three strokes a day that took us to 228 last year, and 841 being the day of my arrest. So 390 days later will be tomorrow, be the 841st day of this certain something I couldn't remember. Well, it's the 840th day today of Operation Olive Branch. The significance of that is YEHWEH's second olive branch is standing before your faces. But the other significance of it is Operation Olive Branch in Syria. How that ties into the anointing of Hazael to YEHWEH sees your rebellion to him, but sees everything. Sees my crying out to him and such. But Operation Olive Branch plus 840 days today, parallel to 84 hours of my death and different things. And I'm going to keep going on about the wine shipment been delayed. I'm going to talk about that in a little later on this video. But that's remarkable, because is he going to hold this back? And they got a notification. I'm going to go through the times in a little bit, but a couple of them, not all of them, everything, but got a notification on the app, the UPS app, said, which, by the way, all the UPS apps, all the tracking numbers for UPS start off 1Z. There is only one Drew Bell standing before your faces. But anyway, it said, due to circumstances beyond our control, the wine came to Goodyear at 8:53 p.m. last night. Amazing. I'm going to get into that. I didn't want to start with that already, but I'll skip to it, but get to it later. But wow. What that means, with what 8:53 means and different things. But then 7 hours and 7 minutes later, seven months and 7 days is 217. He sent the flood on 217. But 7 hours and 7 minutes later, they made a post at 5 a.m. exactly today, 5 a.m. This morning, that due to circumstances out of our control. Well, YEHWEH's in control, so he can continue to shorten the days as long as he wants. I mean, I've been thinking about this a lot, that the wine, I guess I will get to some of it, but that wine will be, so I don't leave it later, but it's not in the notes, but the wine will get here on, to St. John's anyway, on 5/11. I don't know if I'll hold back, but 5/11 was Elijah's, goes 7 days from, I've talked about in previous videos, but from 5/04, all wine between, and 5/11 on Satan's calendar, but 5/04 on YEHWEH's calendar was the beginning of day number one of all wine between 10 of days, to be increased, so even nine of 5/18. Last night was night number 5/18 of no wine. But, and other things too, if, when, and that's still a live hand grenade as well, ties into this, but it looks like it's going to be 5/19, 5/20, and 5/21. 5/21 was the Elijah dream. If you remember right, if you go back and listen to the videos, if people haven't seen it, and people have, go back and listen to it, with the Elijah dream, the Elijah phone call dream, it's called Elijah phone call, the vision. Amazing, though. 687 water tank was crushed. I talked about in yesterday's video, the 687 serial number. It was crushed. And at night 3:30 will be 5:10 on Satan's counter, but it was crushed. Water, symbolic of the wine, the water tank in the back of the rolling thing. Crushed. So different tiers of that certainly is woven into this, but it was crushed by a steamboat mattress, by the way. Steamboat number 93 went off last night at 12:05, midnight, 5 minutes after midnight in Arizona time, 12:05. When I checked this morning, it was 5 hours and 50 minutes after it hit, went off. I just talked about 5:50 in yesterday's video, folks. Yesterday, then that night, five hours and 50 minutes later, after I checked this morning, it went off. There's a delay in them posting it anyway, but I just got up this morning and checked it. He's in control of everything, including this UPS delay. But number 93 for this going into the third year period. The other day I said for 3 years now. It's been going off for three. It's been going off, like according to YEHWEH's restored counter from the 123 start. It's been going off for 2 years. And now 123 would be 2 years, 2 months, and the 28th and 5 days. 65 days. Is that right? Sure. 64, 63, no. 23 minus, it's 5 days, sure. 2 months and 5 days, 65 days. I think 2 years and 65 days now. So it's into the third year. It's the seventh eruption into the third year. 7 minutes, 7 hours, and 7 minutes later, they made the adjustment at 5 a.m. this morning on the wine shipment on the UPS app. So many things, but strongest number 937 for 93-7. And I didn't do all the calculations this morning. I wanted to get out here and do the video for the steamboat eruption to see how the rest of it goes into. But strongest number 937 means contempt, to have contempt. And it's the same as strongest number 936, which is the word used in Zechariah chapter 4. It says, do not have contempt for the day of small things. This is still the day of small things. I'm going to tell you an amazing day of small things. Your king has come to you. Your king to stand before your faces has come to you, riding upon the colt of an ass. Per prophecies like Zechariah and Jacob's end time vision. You think, well, that was Yeshua. Yeshua just was a tear of it. The prophecy from Judah Jacob's 12 blessings, but the blessing for Judah, he said all the 12 blessings are for the end of this era of time. That was 2,000 years ago, folks. If you want to call 2,000 years ago the end of this era of time, when it's a 6,000 year era of time, that sounds like 2/3 of the way through to me, not the end. But you do whatever you want with this. I'll tell you at the end of this, but your king has come to you riding upon an ass's colt, and I'll explain what that means. I've spoken about it in other videos, but I fell short to explain it. And I'm not going to go into great details. These videos have been getting long, and I'm trying to keep it short. But today, 8:40 of Operation Olive Branch, steamboat number 93-7 last night, 7. Strong's number 7 is the word for Abaddon, to perish, but to destroy. But in the revelations of his two sons, of his anointing, Apollyon in the Greek and Abaddon in the Hebrew, death, the destroying angel, the destroying messenger. By the way, I didn't say those wine bottles, all those, like the seal that broke, those seals broken on the wine bottles, starting with the fifth seal. All of them, even their corks and stuff, have, and all their emblems on their app and everything, is a wine bottle with two wings and such. Two wings of a great eagle and so on. It's just amazing, the symbolism. All the symbolism, you guys are being drunk off the wine of your fornication. It ain't about my drunkenness. It's about your drunkenness. Staggering drunk. Playing the whore to our maker and loving every minute of it. Loving every gulp of your filthy waters that come out from your, that aren't his living waters, that come out from your broken cisterns. Which, by the way, 953, I'm going to jump to that in case I forget later, but 953 is the word for pit. Joseph was thrown in a pit by his brothers. And I am jumping ahead now because I want to say some things. But the pit, it's amazing. Because he was thrown in a pit. He went to get his brothers at Shechem, which is going to tie into this later about this riding upon asses, coming upon a colt of an ass. But Shechem, he went to Shechem to look for his brothers that day. And they had moved to Dothan. Dothan is between two, it means two wells. Yehweh's camp now, Sukkoth. By the way, before Jacob came to Shechem, where he drilled Jacob's well, which ties into Yeshua's prophecy with the woman who thirsted for the woman of Samaria, which are all Samaritans, but scattered descendants of Israel, Samaritans clearly. But he came to that. He came to that well, Jacob's well. But Jacob dug it in Shechem. He paid 100 shekels for that parcel of ground from Hamar, the ass. And of course, Shechem was his son, the colt of an ass. So I'm kind of jumping a little bit here ahead, but I hopefully I'll expand upon it and not miss the key nuggets here. But anyway, Jacob went back to Shechem to look for his brothers, and they weren't there. So they said, well, they went to Dothan. Dothan is only missing two places, and the other one is Elisha. When they're looking for Elisha's replacement, Elisha, the king of Syria, I think it's there's Assyria or Syria, I can't remember in that particular instance. And I also want to apologize, I kind of blended. I said that Micaiah prophecy, it was chapter 20 the other day in 1 Kings, it's chapter 22. But I had chapter 20 in my mind because of the situation with Ben-Hadad, which I was also talking about with the 32 princes and the 232 princes and the 7,000 men. I got things kind of, my wires crossed over. I apologize for that. But mixing jumbling events. But he went to Dothan. But Yehweh has caused Sukkoth now and Shechem. That's actually between two wells. Hunting Yehweh, we can't use the wells Because, I mean, when we went to the one we have permission to use, but we went there to get waters one time way back after the 920 waypoint of him bringing us to Shechem. Excuse me, to Sukkoth. But to pitch the ridge tent, which I don't think I'll forget that later, but it's between two wells, but we went one night to get water. We have permission from one of the local residents here. The other one's a community well, which we certainly don't have permission to get on account of you stealing from our maker. But the other one, the guy said, come get waters anytime you want. But they set up a game camera, so we haven't been able to go back there. I'm sure as they hunt YEHWEH's anointed down, I'm sure they got a game camera set up the other of the Dotam wells, two wells. But there they threw him in a pit. Anyway, amazing. Because Jacob's well at Shechem, by the way, was that's a prophecy for Yeshua, given the living waters that flow out from my belly prophecy. The one who believes, Yeshua said that one, all living waters will flow out of the belly of one who believes, John 7:37 and 38. Quite simple. But I did want to, I did caught something else in my notes and looking down on before I get started with the video too and the subject and more of it getting around today. But those two orders I talked about yesterday's video of grain, the two cakes baked on the coals just for with a strength of 40 days and 40 nights. Well, one of them shipped to St. John's already. I was expecting to get it delivered with the wine tonight. I might hold off because the fund's paying for the delivery, and I don't know. But I'm jumping ahead. But anyway, one of them, I told you yesterday in the video, is one of them is 215 pounds, paralleling the day number one of his second feast of the backup feast, that which is unleavened and such, and other things as well. But 215 pounds, and I said the other one's 145 pounds, paralleling that court that I couldn't go to. Led to the arrest warrant that's in place for my arrest because I haven't been able to go to that court. Meaning 145 pounds for day number 145 is that 525 waypoint. Well, 145 plus 215 is 360, one smooth stone. What are the odds? And consider and keep in mind that they are the two cakes baked on the coals. The coals have been given in my hand, about ready to be given in my hand. And he keeps holding this back and could be holding it back now on today's waypoint. Today is the 8th smooth stone anniversary of the beginning of the Most High Elohim's ultimate physical manifestation of his sign of the dove, aka his sign of Jonah. Truly amazing on this ark throne waypoint. The anniversary of the day that his servant David brought up the ark from Obed-Edom's house after 3 months, and how this ties into it. Oh, it's amazing. I'm not going to go into very many details today. It's the day he spit me out of the belly of the plane with his restored calendar. His restored 3-day months that contain his restored Sabbaths and stuff. This sign of the dove is all about his restored calendar, folks. It's all about his restored calendar. His restoration of all things, but specifically about his restored calendar. His Sabbaths and the rest of his restored appointed times. Truly amazing. I want to make sure, too, I got the whole thing on the chapter. No, number 7, eruption number 7 of this third year. I told you meant Abaddon for the destroyer, but to perish is how it's translated typically. But Strong's number 93 for it being a 93rd eruption during these now 2 years and 65 days. 65 days following from that first eruption landing on today is amazing. Because of his 65 days of a day for a year of his Emmanuel Manchah Mahershala Kushbaz prophecy. But Strong's number 93 is just used one place for the 93rd eruption. It's translated nuts in his song of his beloved, yours truly stand before your faces, and ties into Agar, which is one of his proverbs for now too, and stuff, the gathering, the nut gatherer, if you will, but the garden of nuts is how it's translated in that song. Truly amazing, because the gathering is definitely at hand. But anyway, there are several different. I'm going to do a little bit of reading here just because I want to catch that I wrote these things down, but I want to make sure I get it. But there are several different elements that he's woven into this sign of the dove, going back to him causing his servant, the dove, to be spit out of the belly of the ocean traversing plane after those and 3 days and three nights in the belly. It's going to be the belly of the ocean, the great ocean fish, the great fish. Those 3 days and three nights and such, going back to that, and him spit me out of the belly of the plane and such, and even the three three days and three nights that his only begotten son was in the belly of the tomb and such. Of course, was in the belly of the tomb for 17 days, encompassing per his Jeremiah chapter 32 prophecy. And these events have flowed into today's eight smooth stone anniversary. I mean, Yeshua, just look at eight smooth stones there. I'm getting ahead of myself here too, but eight smooth stones. The eighth day of Daniel's 21 days, today's 21,000th day of my life, but the eighth day of Daniel's 21 days was the day Yeshua rode into Jerusalem upon the colt of an ass. But anyway, but the eighth smooth stone anniversary, him spewing his servant the dove at this time out from the belly of the great ocean traversing plain into the midst of the chief seat of the scattered descendants of Israel. It's all quite amazing. Kind of jumping around, I went back to my writing, and hopefully it made sense, flowed with it. But anyway, today's sixth day / third day, 3 days and 3 days, 3 days and three nights, but 6 days, the sixth day prophecy leading to this king waypoint, this the king standing before your faces. And maybe it's all it is this video. Maybe he's going to continue to hold it back. 40 days are interesting. 40 days before the Emmanuel Manshah, Meher Shalal Kushbaz and his twin sister Rachel and the faithful witness twins Zechariah and Uriah be born, 40 days would be 405, which is the living creature's waypoint for chapter 1 of his end time son of Adam prophecies, aka his Ezekiel prophecies, the four living creatures. 40 days later they'll be born. So that would be 515 on Satan's calendar, of course, with the 40-day mirror. 515 on Satan's calendar. The wine's supposed to be there 511, which was the actual seventh day for beginning. Actually, it was the 10th. With the actual getting the two. Yehweh's messenger came to him two times on 511. Go for 40 days and 40 nights. The actual time. There's a prophetic time from 6:8, encompassing 6:8 to 7:17. But I talked about the earlier videos. But then a couple years ago, he showed there's an actual. 5:12 is the first date of Elijah's actual 40 days. And 6:21 is the last. I told you yesterday about 6:21 on Satan's calendar. Back then, going back there with the parallel, and I'd have to think about it. I could, but I'm going to keep moving on, go back and listen to the video. But 6:21 on Satan's calendar, how it ties into it. It's going to be long already. So much stuff to say. And like I said, when I do these long videos, it takes a long time to upload them. But remarkable. Elijah's 40th day was 5:12, actual 40th day. And he gave that to me a year or two ago, spoke about it in videos. Wow. So I don't know. I might not be having it. Elijah, that day will be 4:21 would be when the, no, excuse me, 4:01, the wine will get here. I said yesterday's video, that's the day my palms sweated oil 2 years ago when I was tending to the wicks. My palms sweated oil, both of them just started oozing out oil in my hands, palms in my hands. I mean, and it was crazy. I went down and I showed the dual wives. I said, this is just crazy. I think I still had it on me at that point, wiped it off when I came down, but I'm pretty sure I showed them. Find out when I get back to camp. Maybe she don't remember, I don't know, but I certainly told them about it. But I'm pretty sure I didn't. I might have had something to wipe it off up there. I can't remember. But it was pretty crazy. As I was tending to the wicks now, they've turned into the Abraham lamps. Yeah. But today's sixth day, third day, is indeed a big part of the sign of the dove. And it's just huge today. Just huge. 328 Ark Throne Waypoint. Being the 21,000th day of my life. And of course, tomorrow would be the day I thought my face was going to shine. Maybe. I don't know. But boy, this wine shipment, him holding us back. Circumstances beyond our control, UPS said. Duh. I've never had a little orange, a little yellow caution signal with an exclamation point in it for that before. I get exceptions. Nobody there to sign. The exception, it says exception. Just like you get an exception. No one there to sign, so they couldn't deliver it. But it said exception. Due to circumstances beyond our control, I can read it to you, but the phone's doing the recording, so I can't. We're not able to complete the delivery today. Amazing. Reality. Reality is, folks, the testimony of his word was recorded upon the here and the now. and his two sons of his Zechariah 4:14 holy anointing oil, and why we're here in the flesh. Recording why we're here in the flesh. To love our Elohim, to love him. And he tests us to know whether we'll love him. That's why he gave us the statutes and judgments. These are the truths, chapter 13, to know whether we would love him or not. You obviously can't say you love him. He gave him our statutes and you don't obey him. Deuteronomy, aka these are the truths, chapter 13 says, he gave us the statutes and judgments to know whether we would love him. So you say, I love him. Liars, liars, filthy liars. How can you say you love him when his word says he gave us his statutes and his judgments to know whether we would love him? For love's sake, he would destroy these people that won't turn back to you. And so for love's sake, do it so the ones that will turn back to you for their children's sake will do so. And you start loving YEHWEH by obeying his statutes and his judgments. That which he's restored with his end time, his 30-day months through his servant, the sign, and through his sign of the dove and through his servant that's standing before your faces, Papa Dove. Crazy stuff. There are many, 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 many wonderful ways to YEHWEH my Elohim has marked today's Ark Throne Sign of the Dove waypoint. Some of which I've talked about in recent videos, but I'm not going to go into a bunch of them. Not going to go into it. However, I'm going to, I'm not going to continue to expand upon them in this video. And there's so many, so many. I mean, for instance, I got the email at the wine had been shipped the other a couple nights ago at 6:19 p.m. Today's the 619th day his altar's been uncovered. But he held it back. He's held back shipping the wine. Wow, is he going to hold this back to the last 40 days and 40 nights? 405? I don't know. Looks like it. By the way, those 24 bottles of wine that are ordered to join up with these 15 bottles that were gifted, the present of Isaiah chapter 18, the present will be brought to YEHWEH. Big timing here with this. The present that Loki Lana. Yeah, amazing. Don't know why. Don't know why I'm doing this, she said. Don't know why. I remember another story of a man that gave his favor up in Montana. He said, I'm not even a nice guy. I don't know why I'm doing this. But YEHWEH put a hook in him. Amazing with the blue roof dream. Amazing. But instead of going into all the details, I'm going to briefly tell you a little bit more about why, that it, how he sent his king to you riding upon the colt of an ass. He began... Yeah, I'll go to speaking here when I get through these notes here, but he began to do so through first sending his Revelation chapter 12, Virgin in the Sky sign, back on the last day of the seventh month of the year 5777 on his restored calendar. Amazing. And then 11 days later, he caused his anointed and the younger of the dual wives to pitch the mother's tent, per the song of his beloved, the mother's tent at Shechem Ridge. Ridge that he caused me to name Shechem because I overlooked the valley of the threshing instrument of Joel 3:14 parallel to what I spoke yesterday, and about 3:14 being the video, the day of the video, with that such being the all wine between 10 of days and the King of Kings cupbearer. But he's holding back on feeling, wow, how many more days can he short days at this point in time? It doesn't matter. It doesn't really matter. But Shechem is Hamar's son. Of course, Hamar is the ass, means the ass. Shechem means the ridge, over this ridge, overlooking it. On 7:21, the come and drink waypoint, where Yeshua stood loud and cried, come and drink, the first of the 16 bottles of wine. Anyway, on 7:21, he caused the elder wife and I to pitch back on that ridge. It was the most we were in hiding. We weren't hiding at the corner of Isaiah chapter 30 yet, lot 60. We weren't hiding yet then. But we were going illegally back to blow the silver trumpet for the last 7 days of the feast that had been extended, the third stroke. So we went back that night, 7:21, and Yeshua said, come and drink. And that's the night that I brought those four bottles of wine with me and cracked the seal, the first seal. It's really amazing. Actually, two, and I forget which seal it is, the third or fourth seal, hurt not the oil and the wine. It's interesting because I have oil being delivered too with this wine for the lamps. I still have the first shipment, the first cake baked on the coals delivered tonight. I don't know. I might just wait because we have limited amount of funds, because as far as I know, the 12 yoke of $100 is not here yet either. It wasn't here yesterday. He keeps holding this back. How can that be? It's been in the mail now for maybe today. It'll get there. I don't know. But if it is, that's 7 days. And just doesn't take the U.S. Postal Service that long, typically, but they are slow mail, but YEHWEH's hand is in this. But the wine set there at the facility after it was given to the shipping lady, ready for UPS to pick it up. I called UPS for something else, by the way. It just doesn't take this long, even with this COVID-19 stuff, to pick it up. Especially a facility like this that's open. It's an essential business, so they're shipping wine like they never shipped it before, it sounds like. They're extremely busy, and they're apologizing for the delays and stuff. But 25 hours and 44 minutes, UPS scanned it in. 25 hours and 44 minutes. That's a day and 1 hour and 44, too. But so there was also a 144 in there. I'm not going to go through all the timeline. But Strong's number 2544 is Hamar, the ass. Again, this is the day of small things, folks. Don't continue to have contempt for the day of small things. But Shechem, the ridge, was amazing. I call it Conception Ridge because that's where those first four messengers of blood, the two conceptions of the Emmanuel Manchild, Mahershalal Kushbaz, and his twin sister Rachel were conceived, and the first conception of the faithful witness twins, Zechariah and Uriah, were of those four messengers of blood, Shechem Ridge. And I mean, hold it back then. I mean, Victor, you know, in the Swede, and he's a Swede, and certainly, and I think I might have talked about it in videos and such, but I have plenty of witnesses to talk about it. But clearly, it overlooked the valley of the threshing floor, like I said, Joel 3:14. Really amazing. Again, I want to remind you, Shechem is where Jacob's well is. The woman from Samaria, scattered descendants of Israel, came there. Yeshua said, I'll give you living waters. Living waters fill up my belly. 7:21. Waters, wine, symbolic of blood. Turn the waters into blood, just like Yeshua did. But, come and drink, waypoint. Stood and cried aloud. All those who thirst for YEHWEH righteousness, hunger and thirst for his righteousness, come and drink. Truly amazing. 100 pieces silver. Jacob paid for that parcel of soil between those two mountains where the blessings and cursings were called out from. Ebal, to make bald, means to make bald. Going to show you your baldness. You're not covered by YEHWEH. Show you the shame of your bald and nakedness. Gezrim, the blessings were called out from Gezrim. Means to cut, I believe. I'm not going to go into it either. I could think about it, but I'm not going to go to it. But 100 days prior to today was 12:18, huge waypoint. 32nd day, those 32 kings, 32nd day that the Emmanuel Manchild, Meher, and his twin sister Rachel been in the womb this fourth time. May have left the womb, they're still in the womb. Amazing, but 12:18 was an amazing waypoint for lots of stuff. Tied into the 2300 days, tied into a bunch of stuff, and I didn't write them all down. I'm not going to sit there, I could scratch my brain here and think about them, but don't matter, because don't matter anyway. But Sukkoth is also this, because that Queen's tent, that 88 square foot tent, paralleling the 88 constellations that YEHWEH caused to be named, paralleling today being day number 88 of the year, this Ark Throne, Sign of the Dove waypoint. 88 square foot tent, the Queen's tent set up for this conception, the day before the conception started, on the first, which would be the third conception of the Emmanuel Manchild, Mahershalal Kushbaz, and his twin sister Rachel. On 10/25, the tent was set up. 10/25 of the 6,000th year of the Ram's Horn release of debts, her seventh day of that first messenger of blood in this count for her. Remarkable. 88 square foot tent. It's called a flex ridge tent. You just can't make this stuff up, folks. Because we didn't. We paid for a little $35 tent, and Walmart substituted it out. They don't substitute a $35 tent for a $114 tent. Matter of fact, that same order, we got an $84 tent. Why didn't they just do two of those? You tell me. Certainly had other tents between them, but 114, parallel on the 114 days of his Haggai, Man of the Feast prophecies, and much, much more. From 7:21, one little continuous of time, to the 9:24, I'll shake the dual heavens and the earth. By the way, today's 188 days, too. You just have to figure it out real easy. From Breganus to Sukkoth, 188 days today for the 188-day earthquake cycle, the 188-day feast cycle, 189-day feast cycle, depending when you compass the Passover. Tomorrow will be 189. So tomorrow will be 188 from the three measures of leavening uncovered. That was on 9/21. Truly amazing. 9 months and 21 days. The number, excuse me, I got a little gnat wanting to come around, a little juniper gnat wanting to come around my face. And like I said, we have a statute. We aren't to eat bugs. One of the many statutes that you guys don't care about. Of course, you say, I don't want to eat bugs, but no, we have to make me unclean. I don't want to be unclean. But truly, truly, truly amazing. 93-7 eruption last night, a steamboat geyser, that Elijah dream with the steamboat mattress. Didn't know a steamboat mattress at the point, but a steamboat, steam engine, steamrollers roll over things, but it was a mattress on top of the water tank. I think that was before we got the steamboat. I can't remember for sure the steamboat mattress for the birth of these children, which has since been stolen from Lot 60 along with everything else. Generator, all sorts of stuff. All sorts of stuff. Food supplies and amazing. On account of you stealing this, because you guys stealing from our maker. My arrest warrant, everything. It's because of you guys stealing from our maker. The fact that I've been stranded here for 373 days in the wilderness now, on account of you stealing from our maker. It's all what it is. But this flex ridge tent, behold, your king comes to you riding upon the colt of an ass. Shechem. Shechem was accused of raping Dinah. Did he really? The Hebrew language, did he rape her? She went to go visit the daughters of the land. Why? She shouldn't be. She'd be separated to YEHWEH. I said yesterday, Jacob was still in the learning process too, and Jacob certainly realized this, but she went to go deliver the, to go visit them. And the Hebrew word is 6031. It says 6030, mentioned that, but 6030 means answer. The Hebrew 6031 is the exact same word, to answer. It typically translated humble or afflict, the 6031. They don't want to translate answer because answer doesn't fit. But does it? We answer a person with truth or not. We answer a person with righteousness or not. But he answered her. And it says later when it says she was defiled, it's the word for made unclean. Made unclean. And then, of course, Simeon and... Simeon and Levi, yeah, I think actually, I just now remembered what that word, Gerizim means, cut off, mountain cut off. I'm sorry, Gerizim, the blessing, that can be cut off. You're being cut off because you're rebellion to our maker. But, said he answered her, he loved her, he spoke from his heart, when you read that, but wrote from upon his heart, when you look up the words, he spoke upon his heart. Did he really rape her? He said in the next verse, spoke upon his heart to her. So, did she consent? He asked of her. So, we're going to keep that in mind every time you see that word ask at 6031, because they don't want to call it 6030, because the definition to ask, or to, excuse me, to answer, excuse me, to answer, he answered her, not ask, I'm sorry, answer. He answered her. Did he answer her? Did he answer her flirtation? Of course, his brother said she's unclean, she's defiled. But anyway, they said, should we let him treat our sister at the end whenever Jacob got mad at him for killing all those men? Cause him to be circumcised, associated with 3 days there too. Now we got a 3-day delay on this wine, but cause him to be circumcised. What did the other men do? Of course, they should have been destroyed anyway by being pagans, but that's not why they destroyed. Did they destroy for answering Dinah? Answering her. But I've been accused of rape too, by the way. Just like Shechem. I mean, with the younger wife. Not by her by any means, but now she's like, oh, well, you know. So you guys have all heard the story on these videos if you listen to them. She simply obeyed Yahweh's word too, and so did I. She knew it. She knew. She's the one that told me about Psalms 45. King's daughter being brought into the king with embroiderings. She said, what about this verse? She came to me with it when all that happened after the virgin in the sky sign. But her brother accuses me of rape. Others probably do too. My family, my own family, they know me better than that. I obeyed Yahweh's word. But anyway, Shechem. The ass's colt. I've come riding upon an ass's colt. I've come riding upon this wine, folks. Starting with the 25-hour and 44-minute delay. Hamar, the ass. It's just what it is. It's what it is. This whole thing of Goodyear, like I said, 9:53 p.m. it got to Goodyear. Most shipments we get from UPS go through Phoenix. But this wine goes through Goodyear because it comes from California, I guess. So it goes through Goodyear and then up to Sholo, Arizona. I said, we ain't bluffing. Every time I think of Sholo, I think we ain't bluffing here. He's holding this back, but he ain't bluffing. 9:53 p.m. for that pit that Joseph was in. going back into Dotan, which I jumped to that and explained that already, so I'm not going to do it again for the sake of trying to keep this short, but truly amazing. Joseph went to Shechem to find his brothers. Weren't there when Dotan, two wells, Elisha was living in Dotan when the king of Syria, or Assyria, I'm not sure, came to hunt him down. I apologize for not knowing that for sure. Those two places, used three times, but in those two verses. By the way, I am Elisha. And I'm Elisha. Prophecies for the here and the now. I'm also Moses. Coming in similitude to Moses. Coming in similitude as it was in the days of Noah. Noah, only one left with those eight. I could just go on and on and on and on. But last night's steamboat eruption was awesome. By the way, that 11 days later, we set up, I don't know if I said this, but 221st day of the year, 811. Whenever that conception, that tent set up at Shechem, Conception Ridge, which I've since been accused of raping her since what happened that day on 8/11, on the 221st day. 221st day was the 1290th day of his Daniel prophecy last year. I was arrested 8 days later on 229. I could just go on and on and on, folks. But this is real and it's happening. Whether he continues to shorten the days or not, your king has come to you riding upon the colt of an ass.